Hey everyone, welcome to Jotform. My name is Kimberly, and today we're going to be setting up an autoresponder and notification emails when someone submits a form. So for me, I have an assistant, so I want her to be able to get emails every single time someone submits a form. So we're going to walk through what that looks like. So let's head to the dashboard. All right, so you can see I already have a ton of forms ready to go, but there is one form that I want my assistant to be involved in knowing who is setting up calls with me, and it's going to be this developmental call. So I'm going to go in and I'm going to click on edit form, and you can see I have my form already done and ready to go. So at the top, I'm going to click on settings, and then over on the left hand side, it has emails. First, you can already see that Jotform sends me an email letting me know that someone has submitted a form. Now, when we click on add an email, we have two different options. The first one is to get a notification email. This is what I'm going to want my assistant to get. And then we have an autoresponder email. This is what the person who fills out your form gets once they submit their form. Let's start there. Let's start with the autoresponder email. So just basic, this is what it looks like no matter what. If you don't edit it, this is what they're going to get. Now, one thing that you can do is you can pretty much edit any of these things if you'd like. And even in the email subject, you can change what that looks like as well. You can even use this drop down where it says form fields to change what that looks like. So right now it says, we have received a response for form title. And that's this one right here, or if we can add their name as well if we want. I'm going to go ahead and leave it as the form title. Just know that if you want to change that, you definitely can. Next up is recipients. So the sender name and the sender email, those are both going to be you, the person who created the form. And then under recipient email, make sure that the email field is chosen. And then if we slide over to advanced, there's a lot of other features that we can turn off or on depending on what we want this email to do. Now, if we want it to send on an edit, so if they go back in and make changes, do we want to receive an email letting us know that they've made an edit? I do, so I'm going to turn that on. Next up is a PDF attachment. So if you're wanting to send them a PDF, you can do that here. You can turn it on. We can even send the email later. We can delay it a little bit. We can also hide empty fields and update the email. Now, this submission, this is pretty much what I'm going to want it to look like whenever it gets to my person. Now, I can also send a test email, but we're going to do that in real time here in a second. So I'm going to go ahead and save this. Now, that is for them to receive an email after they have completed the form. Another thing that we can do, and what I am needing to do, is I need my assistant to receive an email once a submission has been submitted. So what we're going to do now is we're going to click add an email, and we're going to do a notification email. It's going to look very similar, right? So we have the email subject, which we can also edit this here. I'm going to put submission for. Right now, under recipients, we can make this look however we want to look. So right now it has the sender name being the name of the person who filled out the form. I'm going to move these just to select, or like please select, because the only thing that we're needing is the recipient email. And I'm actually going to leave it as my email, so that way my assistant isn't confused whenever she gets this test email. And then again, we can go into advanced and we can edit any of these things as well. But I'm going to save. And I'm going to go ahead and go to publish, and I'm going to open the form, give it a quick fill out, and then submit, head to my email, and we can see what those emails look like in my inbox. Okay, I have everything filled out, so let's go ahead and hit the submit button, and let's head to my email. Here we go. So this first one, we have received your response for the developmental call. So this is if I was the person filling it out. This is the autoresponder sending me my submission responses. The next one up here, this is going to be the one that is going to go to my assistant, right? It says resubmission for developmental call. And so this will let her know someone has scheduled a call with me and to get the things that I need in order. Now, the other one that I mentioned where Jotform automatically sends me an email, I have some rules set up in Gmail to where it automatically comes over to my Jotform folder. But there you go. The submissions, the autoresponders, the notification emails, everything working perfectly. So if you guys have any questions about how to set up your own autoresponder email or notification emails, just drop it down below in the comments and we'll be sure to help. Thanks, guys.